September 10th, 2020, was the bicentennial of laying the cornerstone of Fort Snelling, the first U.S. settlement in this region and a major milestone in the westward expansion of the nation. The Friends of Fort Snelling worked for several years to plan the bicentennial. Unfortunately, several factors prevented that from happening. Highway construction. The Minnesota Department of Transportation began major repairs on the roads around the fort. The COVID-19 pandemic. On March 17th, the governor of Minnesota issued a series of executive orders restricting businesses, schools, restaurants, and public gatherings. Face masks and social distancing protocols were adopted. Social unrest. On May 31st, a video of George Floyd, a black man, pleading for his life and dying under the knee of a white Minneapolis police officer, ignited protests and riots in Minneapolis and around the world. On June 10th, American Indians and supporters toppled the statue of Christopher Columbus on state capitol grounds. This is an historical account of various Fort Snelling sites recorded on that bicentennial day. This is the confluence of the Mississippi and Minnesota rivers that Zebulon Pike visited in 1805. He acquired land from several Dakota representatives and promised a U.S. fort and government trading post. In 1819, Colonel Henry Leavenworth led an expedition to site and build a fort. The Mendota Dakota welcomed the soldiers, hoping the fort would bring peace. Coldwater Spring was the source of fresh water for the fort. Near Coldwater Spring, an early trading post was built to provision the soldiers building the fort. It is now part of the National Park Service, Mississippi National River and Recreation Area. In 1820, Colonel Josiah Snelling began his supervision of construction of the fort, which was completed in 1826. The Minnesota Historical Society closed the Visitor Center for the historic fort in 2019 and has deconstructed it. The Minnesota Historical Society is renovating the 1904 Cavalry Barracks for a new visitor center. Fort Snelling State Park was open, but the visitor center was closed by the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources. Transportation by vehicles, barge, and light rail continued at reduced numbers. The federal government's Henry A. Whipple Building, the Common Bond Community's Upper Post Veterans Community, and other facilities were opened for limited activities. The U.S. Air Force Officers Club at Fort Snelling has been closed since 2015. Buildings in the upper post continue receiving permanent stabilization work. Upper Post Flats, a development project of the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources and the Dominion Corporation, is in the planning stages to renovate some of the buildings into affordable housing. The Leonard H. Nieman Youth Athletic Complex, operated by the Minneapolis Park and Recreation Board, was quiet. The Boy Scouts of America Northern Star Council Base Camp, including the Leadership Center, was open for limited activities. Fort Snelling National Cemetery remained open. Although the visitor center in Fort Snelling State Park was closed, its trails and roads were open.
So